Today we shall discuss about Atlas oscillator and Colpitts oscillator. It is a LC oscillator which uses two inductors and one capacitor in its tank circuit. And two inductors L1 and L2 are connected in series across a capacitor C to complete the tank circuit. This RFC will produce a 180 degree phase shift and tank circuit will produce 180 degree phase shift. We want 360 degree phase shift. For Barr-Casson-Butterian, 360 degree phase shift should be there. The resistance R1, R2 and RE will provide necessary bias to the circuit. The capacitor CC1, the capacitor CC1, CC2 are the coupling capacitors. This is a feedback network, okay? Feedback network and tank circuit. Feedback network consists of tank circuit made up of two inductors L1 and L2. That is, two inductors L1 and L2, capacitor C. RF choke is a large inductor. It serves two functions. It acts as a DC short to the power supply VCC. It acts as an open circuit for AC. The RFC, that is radio frequency choke, is used to achieve isolation between AC and DC conditions. The CE amplifier provides a phase shift of 180 degree, and when VCC is switched on, capacitor C gets charged and tank circuit will provide 180 degree phase shift. CE amplifier will produce 180 degree phase shift and the tank circuit will produce 180 degree phase shift. When VCC is switched on, capacitor C will get charged. At that situation, the 180 degree phase shift will be it will provide. When feedback is adjusted such that AB equal to 1, okay, the circuit works as an oscillator. The frequency of oscillation is given by F is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi square root of L equation into C. There are two inductors L1 and L2 in series, hence equivalent inductance of L tank circuit is L equation is equal to L1 plus L2. If mutual inductance, that is M, is considered while determining the equivalent inductance, then L equation is equal to L1 plus L2 plus 2 into M. The condition for sustained is HF equal to L1 plus M divided by L plus M. Neglecting the mutual inductance, the condition for the sustained oscillations is given by HFE greater than or equal to L1 divided by L2. This is the Atlas oscillator. Derive an expression for a frequency of an oscillation of Atlas oscillator. We will consider the tank circuit, that is L1, L2 and capacitor C, okay, and mutual inductance. In feedback circuit, sum of all the three reactants must be equal to 0. That is JXL1, JXL2 plus 1 divided by JXE is equal to 0. JXL1 plus JXL2 minus 1 divided by J can be written as minus J. Okay. So minus JXE is equal to 0. If you take out J as common, XL1 plus XL2 close bracket is equal to JXE. J get cancelled. So omega. If you substitute XL1 value, XL2 value, omega L1 plus omega L2 is equal to 1 divided by omega C. Omega, if you take out omega common, L1 plus L2 is equal to 1 divided by omega C. Multiply like this, okay? Omega square is equal to 1 divided by L1 plus L2 into C. L1 plus L2 is a L equation. So omega square is equal to 1 divided by L equation into C. Omega can be written as what? 2 pi F. Okay. Omega square it is. So omega is equal to 1 divided by square root of L equation C. 2 pi F. Omega value is 2 pi F. Substitute 2 pi F is equal to 1 divided by square root of L equation into C. So F is equal to what we get? 1 divided by 2 pi square root of L equation into C. This is what expression for frequency, expression for Hartley oscillator. Next, we shall discuss about the Colpitts oscillator. With the help of a neat circuit diagram, explain transistor Colpitts oscillator. Write the expression for the frequency of oscillation. In this also tank circuit, but in this case the tank circuit Colpitts oscillator consists of two capacitors and one inductor. When you compare with our Hartley oscillator, we use two inductors and one capacitor. In this case, we use two capacitors and one inductor in Colpitts oscillator. The two capacitors C1 and C2 are connected in series across the inductor L. Same, okay, instead of inductor, we use capacitor. Here, intact circuit C1, C2 and L. Okay, this same RFC will produce 180 degree phase shift and tank circuit will produce 180 degree phase shift. The resistance R1, R2, RE will provide the necessary bias to the circuit, and CC1, CC2 are the coupling capacitors. The capacitance divider C1, C2 in tank circuit will provide a necessary feedback for oscillations. The RFC, that is radio frequency choke, is used to achieve the isolation between AC and DC conditions. The CE amplifier provides a phase shift of 180 degree. When the supply is switched on, the oscillatory current set up the tank, it produces a AC voltage across C1 and C2. Tank circuit will provide 180 degree phase shift. What happens when the supply is on, the oscillatory current will set up in the tank circuit. It will produce a AC voltage across a C1 and C2. That will produce that total overall tank circuit will produce 180 degree phase shift. When feedback is adjusted such that AV is equal to 1, the circuit works as an oscillator. The output is coupled to the load via transformer. Next, transformer coupling has the following advantages. It provides a electrical isolation between the oscillator output and the load. It provides a impedance matching between the oscillator output and the load. The frequency of oscillation is given by F is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi square root of L into C equation. In this case, Colpitts oscillator, you write C equation. C equation is equal to C1 into C2 divided by C1 plus C2. The condition for sustained oscillation is HFE greater than or equal to C2 divided by C1. Derivation and expression for frequency of oscillation of Colpitts oscillator. We will consider the feedback circuit, or we can call it as tank circuit. The frequency of oscillation can be easily obtained in feedback circuit shown in figure. Sum of all the three reactants must be equal to 0. 1 divided by JXC1 plus 1 divided by JXC2 plus JXCL. XCL is equal to 0. In this, we are considering two capacitance. So 1 divided by J can be written as minus J. Okay. Minus JXC1 minus JXC2 plus JXL is equal to 0. JXCL is equal to JXC1 plus JXC2. JXCL is equal to, take out J common, J get cancelled. So you'll substitute the values of XL, XC. Okay, so omega L is equal to 1 divided by omega C1 plus 1 divided by omega C2. Omega L is equal to 1 divided by omega, you take out 1 divided by omega as common, so you'll get 1 divided by C1 plus 1 divided by C2. Omega square is equal to 1 divided by L, close bracket, take out LCM, you'll get C1 plus C2 divided by C1 into C2. Omega value is 2 pi F. Omega value is 2 pi F. So 2 pi F whole square is equal to 1 divided by L C1 C2 divided by C1 plus 2 pi square to 1 divided by L into, where C equation is equal to C1 into C2 divided by C1 plus C2. 2 pi F is equal to 1 divided by square root of L C equation. Okay, this square will get here. Okay, so square root you will get. 2 pi f is equal to 1 divided by square root of L into C equation. So this can be written as f is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi square root of L into C equation. The crystal oscillator. Next, we shall discuss about the crystal oscillator. The crystal are the either naturally occurring or synthetically manufactured, okay, exhibiting the piezoelectric effect. This crystal oscillator, the piezoelectric effect means under the influence of the mechanical pressure, the crystal vibrates and the voltage gets generated across the opposite face of the crystal. Conversely, if the crystal is subjected to AC voltage, it vibrates, causing a mechanical distortion in the crystal shape. Every crystal has its own resonating frequency resonating frequency. Constructional details. The natural shape of a quartz crystal is hexagonal prism, but for its practical use, it is cut to rectangular slab. The slab is taken, slab is then mounted between the two metal plates. Okay, slab is then mounted between the two metal plates. The metal plates are called holding plates and they hold the crystal slab in between them. You can observe here holding plate and crystal slab. Okay, symbolic representation of crystal. Next, frequency response of crystal, that is, first we shall discuss series resonance. Okay, when the frequency of the AC source is equal to the frequency FS, the current through the crystal becomes maximum I maximum. You can observe here the waveform. Okay, when the frequency of the AC source is equal to the frequency FS, the current through the crystal will become maximum. This condition is called the series resonance FR, and FS is called the series resonant frequency. Series resonance occurs when the reactance of L is equal to the reactance of C. When series resonance will occur? When the reactance of L is equal to the reactance of C. At that situation, series resonance will occur. The series resonance RLC branch XL is equal to XC. XL value is omega L. XC value is 1 divided by omega C. Omega square is equal to 1 divided by L C. Okay. Omega is equal to 1 divided by square root of L C. F is equal to, or you can write directly 2 pi F. They have substituted the omega value. So directly F is equal to, or we can write Fs because we are doing the series resonance, 2 pi. Since current is maximum, the impedance of the crystal is also, crystal will be minimum. Okay, next, parallel resonance. Parallel resonance, when the frequency of the AC source is equal to the frequency, that is FP, will be greater than FS, the current through the crystal becomes minimum, I minimum. This condition is called parallel resonance. In this case, in series resonance, I will be maximum. In parallel resonance, I will be minimum. The parallel resonance occurs when the reactance of L is equal to the sum of the reactants, that is, XL is equal to XCM and XC. Okay, if omega L is equal to 1 divided by omega CM plus 1 divided by omega C, mutual capacitance. Okay, CM means omega L is equal to 1 divided by omega, they have taken common, so you will get 1 divided by CM plus 1 divided by C, close bracket, omega square. Okay, this they have multiplied, so you will get omega square is equal to 1 divided by L. Okay, this open bracket, 1 divided by CM plus 1 divided by C, close bracket. Taking 1 divided by CL Cp is equal to 1 divided by Cm plus 1 divided by C. They have solved here 1 divided by L open bracket Cm plus C divided by C into Cm. Okay, after taking LCM, you'll get like this. Okay, this can be written as Cp. Cp is equal to C into Cm divided by C plus Cm. Okay, omega square is equal to 1 divided by L into Cp. Omega is equal to 1 divided by square root of L into Cp. 2 pi f is equal to 1 divided by square root of L into Cp. Fp is equal to 1 divided by here 1 divided by 2 pi. Okay, 2 pi square root of L into Cp. Okay, this is what you will get. First, xl is equal to xcm plus xc. Here omega l is equal to, here omega l means xl. Okay, omega into l. Okay, not omega in l. So 1 divided by l they will consider here. This is also omega l. Okay, omega square is equal to 1 divided by l. Don't think where it came. Since the current is minimum, the impedance of the crystal is maximum. But when you take series resonance, current will be maximum, the impedance of the crystal will be minimum. Okay. Explain characteristics of a quartz crystal with a neat diagram. Explain the crystal oscillator in parallel resonance circuit. Characteristics of a quartz crystal. AC equivalent circuit. This is the AC equivalent circuit, mounted piezoelectric crystal and AC equivalent circuit of crystal. Okay, CM, R, L, C. When a crystal is not vibrating, it is equivalent to a capacitance due to the mechanical mounting of the crystal. They are saying that when crystal is not vibrating, it is equivalent to the what? It is equivalent to the capacitance due to the mechanical mounting of the crystal. Such a capacitance existing due to the two metal plates. You can observe this is a two metal plates separated by a dielectric like crystal slab is called mounting capacitance, denoted as CM. When it is not vibrating, it is equivalent to capacitance due to mechanical mounting. When it is vibrating, there are internal frictional losses which are denoted by a resistance R. While the mass of the crystal, which is indication of its inertia, is represented by an inductance L. Yeah, R is represented as it is internal frictional losses, and L is a inertia. Okay. In vibrating condition, it is having some stiffness, which is represented by a capacitor C. The RLC forms a resonating circuit. The expression for the resonating frequency FR is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi square root of L into C. The crystal frequency is inversely proportional to the thickness of the crystal. F is inversely proportional to the 1 by T. T is a thickness. So, to have very high frequency, thickness of the crystal should be very small, and vice versa. Next, parallel resonance circuit. Okay, this is the circuit for parallel resonance circuit. R1, R2, RFC and RE, C1, C2 and crystal. Okay, Colpitts oscillator can be modified by using the crystal to be an inductor. The crystal behaves as an inductor for frequencies slightly higher than the series resonance frequency. The crystal will behave as an inductor when frequency will be slightly higher than the resonance frequency. Series resonance frequency. Two capacitors C1, C2 required in the tank circuit along with them crystal. The resistance R1, R2, RE will provide DC bias, while the capacitor CE is bypass capacitor. The RFC will provide an isolation between the AC and DC operation. CC1, CC2 are the coupling capacitors, and the resulting circuit frequency is set by the series resonant frequency of the crystal. Change in supply voltage, temperature, transistor parameters have no effect on the circuit operation condition. They are saying that change in supply voltage, temperature, transistor parameters, if any change in supply voltage or temperature and thus the parameters of transistor, then it will not affect on the circuit operation or condition. Hence, good frequency stability is obtained. The series is 490 degree phase shift, and the total phase shift is 0 or 360 degree. When feedback is adjusted, AB equal to 1, the circuit will work as an oscillator. Series resonance frequency FS is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi square root of LC, and the parallel resonance frequency is equal to C equation is equal to CM into C divided by CM plus C. FP is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi square root of L into C equation. The advantages of this, the frequency stability of the crystal is very high. The frequency stability of the crystal is very high. The temperature stability of a crystal is very good. And the frequency drift due to temperature change is negligibly small. Quartz crystals are readily available in nature. Crystal replaces inductor in the tank circuit. As a result, crystal oscillator circuits are less bulky, inexpensive, and lighter in weight. What about disadvantages? Crystals are very delicate and hence require careful handling. The thickness of the crystal is inversely proportional. I have already said F is inversely proportional to the T. Okay. Or F is equal to 1 divided by T. So the thickness of the crystal is inversely proportional to the frequency. Hence, higher frequency crystals are thinner in size and mechanically weak. Next, the advantages for series resonant crystal oscillator. The frequency stability of the crystal is very high in this case. Okay, series resonant crystal oscillator. The temperature stability of a crystal is very good. And next, quartz crystal are readily available in nature. Crystal replaces inductor in the tank circuit. As a result, crystal oscillator are less bulky, inexpensive, and lighter in weight. Same, okay. Series resonant circuit. This is the series resonant circuit. You can observe the crystal where it is connected. Okay, R1, R2, RFC, and VCC. Okay. The crystal behaves as an inductor for a frequency slightly higher than series resonance frequency. This is already we have read. Change in supply voltages, temperature, transistor parameters have no is obtained. Frequency stability of oscillator in the next class, okay?